Hi guys, Chuck here once again for thecheapbastard.net. We'll do part two right now of getting our lawnmower started for the season. And I'm going to tell you about a tool that you may not have in your tool chest yet or in your garage, but you'd probably be better off if you look into maybe acquiring it and getting it in there. So, stage two of getting the lawnmower ready. We've got the freshened up blades on the deck. And now, if I'll show you, the lawnmower won't start. And if you ever encounter this, I'll show you what's going on. Let's get on board. On board the lawnmower now. The choke is out. The brake is in. We're in neutral. We're ready to fire it over. And guess what? I turn the key. Nothing. Not even a sound. Turn it again. Absolutely nothing. This probably means one thing, your battery's been drained out for the season. I'm gonna show you how to overcome this problem with the acquisition of a simple piece of hardware you should probably have in your garage. It'll last you a lifetime, doesn't cost a whole lot of scratch, and will keep all your trucks, your cars, your snowmobiles, your four-wheelers, anything that requires a battery in order to turn over, will get you started right here. Probably pass it every day in the hardware store, haven't looked twice at it. Now you need it.
Go tell that long-tongued liar, go and tell that midnight rider.
Okay, well, it's not mandatory. It's always handy to have a can of either WD-40 or some sort of lubricant or water displacement system. So we'll give this a quick shot. We see we have some corrosion here on the terminals. Might be part of the culprit. Who knows yet? We'll go through the entire process. So we'll hit this real quick. There we go. Shake it up. There we go. We'll let that set for a minute.
Well, you may throw your rock. Hide your hand, working in the dark against your fellow man. But as sure as God made black and white, what's done in the dark will be brought to the light. You can run on for a long time, run on for a long time, run on for a long time. Sooner or later, gotta cut you down. Sooner or later, gotta cut you down.
Okay, with the terminals disconnected, let's get her out of there.
Go tell that long-tongued liar.
Okay, with the battery out of the mower, we're gonna get this thing in the garage and on the bench and get it charged back to life. Okay, with the battery out and set up here on our improvised bench, let's get to work. We'll clean the terminals off, get all that sort of conductive paste and dirt and gunk and schmutz, whatever you wanna call it, off the surfaces so we can make good contact with our charger. Now, a charger can be picked up at most, again, big box or hardware stores from anywhere between $35, $50, all the way up to maybe $120, or hell, even $200, depending on how big time you want to go with this. This one here that we're going to be using, I got from Canadian Tire, cost me $40 on sale, had it for 5 years, never failed me. So, with the terminals clean, let's get it set up. First things first, as you would assume, positive should go on the positive terminal, and negative should go on the negative terminal. Depending on which model you have, you know, your own mileage may vary. So for me, I like to get the clamps on first. Along the way, make sure they don't touch. It's not plugged in, so I can do this. Make sure they don't come in contact with each other, because you're gonna create a situation for yourself. So positive on, negative on. I can feel we've got a good tight connection being made, and let's plug it in. Now I'll set it to a 2-amp charge, a slow charge. Okay, we'll let that set for a couple hours, check on it every second, fourth hour, make sure everything is as it should be. And then by the time that's done, the battery should be charged, should read at 100%. We'll get her back inside the mower and see if she turns over, and who knows, we could be in for a mighty fine season of mowing. We'll check back in a minute, okay? Okay, with the battery all charged up now, let's get to work, get her back inside the mower, turn this baby over and get to cutting some grass now, all right? Okay, with the battery back in the battery box now, before we get everything buttoned back up, I brought along a Brillo pad with me, or a scouring pad if you want, and we're gonna go to work and just clean up these contacts to make sure we get nice, consistent current passing through. Now, you can use a sandpaper, emery board, or whatever you have that's abrasive laying around, just to get this job done. Okay, that contact's pretty clean.
I wanna
spirit carry me. Well, there you go, folks. Right there for a $40 piece of hardware that you should have in your garage anyways. You can keep everything in your yard, whether it be your cars, your snowmobiles, your four-wheelers. Anything you got that runs off a 12-volt battery, keep it charged and fresh and topped off at all times. Look at that. It only took us 2 hours of charging and we're back on the road again. So let's get this grass cut and I'll talk to you guys later. Once again, this has been Chuck for thecheapbastard.net. Maybe tomorrow I'll wanna settle down. Until tomorrow I'll just keep moving on. So if you wanna join me for a while, just grab your hat, come travel like that solo sky. Maybe tomorrow I'll find what I call home. Until tomorrow, you know I'm free to roam.